Name three hardworking shapes and one big bad boss.
You don't sing that song? Then you're a moldy waffle.
Then you get a mix and healthy portion of fun music like tasty recipe. For an unlike star like you ever seen or heard before.
You don't mean.
That's right, everybody. It's Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel from the funniest YouTube video from Shapetales. Join them and discover that why they should have to believe to stand up and believe in themselves, no matter how hard it might be. Get ready to laugh, smile, and join them and sing with them. Even the big bad boss learned a valuable lesson.
You know, I must have forgotten the things that my mom taught me. I was making you guys doing the wrong thing.
It's one big heaping helping old time shapes. Don't miss us. Don't miss the hilarious Saturday morning footmark values and Saturday morning fun. It's Shapetales. Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel. Available now on YouTube.
All right, Alivn. Time for the theme song. Ah, yeah, Jerry. What do I do? Good question. Can you play the guitar?
If you like to talk to tomatoes, if a squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes, up and down the produce aisle, have we got a show for you.
Your hat. Yeah, isn't it the greatest hat you've ever seen?
how cool I am.
I see, said the blind cone. Hey, that reminds me of a letter we just got from Jack DeLodge from Sydney, Australia.
Oh, you don't say.
Well, I do. Now, Jack and his friend, we'll call him Peter Bumba. He said Peter Bumba. So Peter wants to watch his favorite TV show that Jack is not allowed to watch. And he knows it's a bad show. But Peter says if he doesn't watch it, it means he's not cool. What should he do?
Oh, why a pickle? Or a cucumber. Whichever comes first. You know, Jimmy.
Over here, Robin.
You know, Jimmy.
Turn, stop.
Oh, you don't think I get you, Rob?
Yes.
Oh, okay, anyway. You know, Jimmy. I think we're gonna need Cordy to run out for this one. I'll go get her.
Wait, Alivn! Watch out for the tar pit.
Oh. Wait, what do we got a tar pit?
Are you okay?
Hopefully Shapey Magazine didn't mention this. Oh, and also, despite the weird itchiness, I should be good.
Okay, Jack, while I try to get Alivn out of that tar pit, I want you to listen to a story about three boys named Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel who were in a pickle just like yours.
Or a cucumber.
Alivn. That's right. But those weren't their real names. No, their real names were, let's see if we can get this right. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Whoa, nobody can remember those, so we called them their middle names. Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel. Anyways, they came with a bunch of boys and girls as Mr. Rectangle sent them to work at his chocolate factory. Oh, and Mr. Rectangle, we'll get to him later. Who am I? Why, I'm Harold. Anything that goes in and out of Rectangle's chocolate factory has got to come by me. Well, speaking of which, it's almost 8 o'clock. It's time for the morning milk delivery. Here comes
Carla.
Oh, she's my favorite.
Call him Mr. Rectangle.
Now, Mr. Rectangle's not a bad man. He just gets confused. Why his chocolate chip waffles are selling so well, I think he's got big news for his workers. And that's saying something for his workers, breaking out to start out with. So, what's this all have to do with Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel? Well, the trouble starts when Mr. Rectangle makes his little announcement.
Attention, new people! I have an announcement to make. This morning, Mr. Rectangle ships his 2 million chocolate chip waffles.
To celebrate this occasion, for the next 32 minutes, everyone may eat as many waffles as they want. Bon appetit!
Hey, boss, that was awfully nice of you to give away all those chocolate waffles.
Oh, if I could just see the looks on your faces right now. Show their appreciation.
Oh yeah, they're really gonna appreciate you, boss.
Hello. I don't feel very appreciated.
Hey, look, they're lying on the floor like they're super shanty.
You mean I let them eat my waffles, and in return they all want to play Patrick Starr's Hooking?
Wait, boss, those three guys over there—they don't look sheesh.
Thanks, Mr. Rectangle, for your lovely gift on chocolate chips. Yep. Thank you.
Everybody else is lying down, but you three are standing up.
Actually, boss, I think you should be sitting.
I'm standing.
Sitting.
Look, this is sitting and this is standing. I'm standing.
Okay, you're standing.
You're standing? I always thought you were sitting. Why, it's hard to tell, you're a sphere!
What are your names, boys?
I'm Shadrach, but people call me by my middle name, Isaac.
I'm Meshach. People call me by my middle name, Tyler.
I'm a Mendigo. Bye.
They call me Knuckles.
No.
I'm Larry the Cucumber.
Ah! Gabriel. Call me by my middle name, Gabriel.
How would you three like to be our new junior executives?
Hip hip hooray!
then. Mr. Diamond, go get them their ties.
Right away, boss.
Boys, I want to see you guys in my office first thing in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Well, what do you know? Isaac, Tyler, and Gibio did what was right, even though nobody else was doing it. And it paid off, this time at least. But Bob were there for a surprise. So they got into Mr. Rattigo's office the next day.
Well, boys, have I got a surprise for you. The other day I was thinking about the rectangle chocolate waffles and thinking about how wonderful chocolate waffles are and how beautiful the waffles is. And so I thought, if only my workers love waffles just as much as I do. I asked myself this, why don't they love it so much? Do you know why? Because it was small. It's just a teeny tiny waffle that they just eat and they forget about it. Wait, what if the waffle was something that everyone could look up to? And I mean way up to. This is just a model. The real waffles is 110,000 feet high. My workers are still working on it, and it's going to be finished this morning.
Wow, that's a big waffle, sir.
Mm-hmm. And since you guys are my new junior executives, I want you to see it first. But this afternoon, everyone will see the new waffle, and it's going to be a beautiful thing when everybody bows down and sings the waffle song.
I don't think I'm familiar with that particular tune. Could you just tell me, Bard? Thanks.
No, Gabriel, I thought you never asked. And you're welcome. The waffle song would just show how my employees how much they love waffles. How is nothing more important than waffles? How would they do anything for waffles? And it could be something like this.
Stew on my toes, just the waffles, the waffles, the waffles. Yeah, I love the waffles. I gave everything that I had for the waffles. I don't want no hell food when it's time to eat. A big bag of waffles is all that I need. I don't want no buddies to come out and play. I'll sit on my sofa and eat waffles all day. I won't eat onion rings, and I won't eat tofu. That's nothing for sissies, but waffles are cool, yeah.
I don't want no beagles, I don't want no honey. It's one of my
No, 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 wait. This is wrong.
It's I don't like this song.
Sing that song, that you're a moldy waffle.
You don't mean.
But I'm sure that won't happen. All right, see you later. Oh dear.
I think we're in a pickle.
Now this was quite a pickle, or a cucumber, whichever comes first. The waffle song was full of stuff that it was wrong. But if they don't sing it, Mr. Rattigo was gonna throw them into the toaster. Do if you were there. Better hold that thought, because the ceremony is about to begin.
Thank you for attending today's festivities. With my great pleasure, I present to you the object of affection, your new best friend, the one and only Waffle. Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel are new junior executives?
I think so. Maybe they're stuck.
Let's find out. I said it's time to sing the waffle song.
Come on, guys. Sing the song. Everybody's doing it.
Sing the song.
They ain't singing, Mike.
Sing! Is that the waffle song?
Are you crazy? That's the
wrong song! Know that wherever you are, it is never too far. If you think of me,
start singing that song as I throw you in the toaster. Guards, seize them. Take them to the toaster.
Listen to the call. Oh, how sweet his voice.
That's what I'm doing.
that grandpa was stroked like a chorus of little birds. I spoke to that. Listen to the tone. All the shades.
Tyler! What? We gotta pick a
not mistaken, that truck belongs to me. Oh no! I think my truck is full of garbage. Dump it out. Mr. Diamond?
Yeah, poor baby, bud.
Mr. Diamond?
What do you mean, Mike? I'll say this once, and this will be my last time. Nobody toasts my waffles!
Listen up, young lady. If you don't plug that truck back in, you are going to be in big trouble. Stand up to me again. Save you from the fiery toaster. I must have forgotten the things that my mom taught me. I was making you guys doing the wrong thing. Can you guys accept my apologies?
We accept it.
Whew, thank goodness. So, is there any way I can make it up to you?
Yeah, you can sing one of our songs.
Well, can you show me how it goes? Thanks.
Do you know, Mr. Rectangle? I thought you never asked. And you're welcome.
That's beautiful. I've got a little respect for that little woman. I bet you got a bunch of love. Even though the things they do were wrong.
Stand up,
everybody tells you that you gotta be cool. Remember what you learned in children's Sunday school? Just check it out.
Uh-huh.
The Bible Trails is what it's all about.
Oh, well, that's right.
Read it! And if you have a question, go ask your dad. And he can tell you if the thing is good or bad. You'll make your day.
Yep.
If you remember what your parents said.
What did I say, boys?
They told us
stand up.
For what you believe in God.
He's the one to help you out.
Was there with you.
One more time now.
Stand up. Oh, you're back. But I
still haven't been able to get out of that tar pit.
I want to get out.
I know, but right now, it's time to talk about what we learned today.
And so we know all of us twilight today. No more has to say in this book.
Wow, you really have a strong addiction to that song.
I know, right? I actually really love that song so much.
See, we know words, words for everyone. Now that the song is done, let's go take a
So, like I said before, it's time to talk about what we learned today. Are you alright, Alivn?
I've got tar in my mouth.
Well, hang in there. So, Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel learned that standing up for what they believed in was very hard, but it was worth it. When all their friends were doing the wrong things, Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel remembered what their parents taught them and got one of them to do the right thing. In the end, wouldn't you know it, the Lord has protected them from the toaster. So what did you learn, Alivn?
Well, I learned that doing something isn't such a good idea. This being cool isn't very cool. I put a bush on my head because Shapetales magazine said it would make me look cool. Even though I didn't see anything, it didn't make me look cool. It made me bump into Thomas the Tank Engine, then it made me fall into the tar pit. And now I can't get out of here. Yeah, I'm gonna be stuck here forever. I'm gonna drown in tar, and I'll never get to go to Las Vegas or hear the screams of excitement from weekly concerts or experience what it's like to be a famous celebrity like Dwayne Johnson, Kevin Hart, Jared Gilman, or Jack Black. Oh, yeah. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Frank, are you finished?
Not yet. I gotta do what you always do. Say dramatic, why?
Why? Why? Why?
Okay, I'm done. Great. Anyway, Alivn, do you see the ladder in there?
Yeah.
I found a certain button. If I push it, the ladder can bring you out of there and you grab it. Okay? Okey-dokey.
Ready!
All right, then. Here it goes.
Boy, free.
Free as a bird.
Well, that's great.
Whoa!
Oh, no, that ain't good.
Don't worry about me. Finish the show. Worry about me later.
Okay, then. Let's see if Cordy 2.0 has a verse for us today. Stand firm and hold to the teachings we pass on to you. Second, Apollofians. No, don't tell me. Ethylian? No, not yet. Apollofians? Okay, tell me.
Thessalonians.
Ah, can't let you out now.
Not yet. Keep going.
Okay, then. Second Thessalonians 2:15. That means remember what your parents teach you. And what you've learned from the Bible. If someone wants you to do something that you know is wrong, stand firm and do what's right. In our story, Isaac, Tyler, and Gabriel stood firm when all their friends were doing things they knew were wrong. So, Jack, is it? Oh, yeah. The next time you go to Peter's house, maybe you could bring some of your favorite videos to watch instead. He might think it's pretty cool. It isn't always easy, but knowing you've done the right thing sure feels good inside. Ain't that right, Jimmy?
That's right, Alivn. Okay, now you can get me out now.
If you'll excuse me, people, I got a spirit to let out of a tar pit. So I'm afraid that's all the time we have for today. But always remember, the Lord made you special, and he loves you very much. Goodbye!
danger sneaks in the huge city. Debacle holds up in each rear entryway. Hazard behind each park seat. The world needs a hero. In any case, not only a standard hero, no. An uncommon hero. A superhero. I am QBT Alivn, otherwise known as Quantum Vile Titanium Alivn. Whenever there is danger, I'll be there. Whenever a helpless shape needs a hero, I will answer. Evil villains, beware. You are no match for the awesome power of QBT Alivn and his super magnetism. You question? What am I saying? Of course you don't doubt. Because if you are, I am watching you. Now, a showing! Well, that didn't work.
Well, hi, kids. I'm Jimmy the Sphere, and that's Alivn the Cone.
I don't think we met before. I just have one of those familiar-sounding names.
Come on, Alivn. I know it's you.
Jimmy, you're not supposed to tell anyone my secret identity.
And?
What do you mean, Anne? That's supposed to be a secret!
Alivn, stop goofing around. We got a show to do.
Crime fighting is no laughing matter.
There is no crime here.
Oh, that's just not fair. Fine. So, Jimmy, might you be able to give me a hand with my super magnetism? It appears to have broken down.
Okay. What's this button for?
Don't! That's the button that turns the magnets off. Ouch. Wow.
Wow, it looks like being a superhero is hard. I think it's about time you go back to being Alivn.
What? No, I don't want to do that.
How come?
All things considered, there's nothing uncommon about just Alivn. He can't do anything flawless, like fly or spare individuals, or have a sweet, cool voice changer in his mask. What I'm saying is, plain old Alivn should just plain boring.
Uh-oh. Someone is not feeling any special?
Not one bit.
Big idea!
And that would be...
I can't... Hey! Ah!
Oh, my...
Alivn! My...
I apologize. Okay, Jimmy, draw back, Jimmy!
Well, what I was going to state is that we...
Ow! That hurts!
Ta-da! Da-da-da-da-da-da, circus! Da-da-da-da-da-da, Alivn circus! Alivn circus! Alivn, poke it up, Alivn!
Really? Okay, as I was stating, we have received a letter from Alyssa Kloner from Seattle, Washington. You see, Alyssa has big sisters. They are really big enough. She says that she loves to do extreme ballist things like play soccer and do some artful dancing, but she's not that big. So Alyssa needs to know what is her expectation.
Miss Clawwither, I know how you feel.
Well, Alyssa and Alivn, QBT Alivn, I'm going to tell you guys a tale about a boy named Davy.
Now, Davy lived in a land called Israel a long time ago. So long ago, there weren't any cars or trains, but they got by with sheep. And that's a lot of sheep around Davy's house. You know why? Because Davy was, in fact, a shepherd.
Is that Davy?
No, that's not him. That's one of his brothers.
What about him?
Nope, another brother.
Him?
Nope, another brother. Davy has a lot of brothers. Aha! There he is!
So is he the sheep or behind the sheep?
Behind the sheep. excuse me, Mr. Sheep.
Ah, so you must be Davy, right?
Like, hi, I'm Davey. I have a great deal of brothers.
Seven brothers. Now, Davey and his brother spent most of their time in the fields taking care of the sheep, which could be very hard because their sheep had an unusual problem.
They fall over. Oh, look, there goes one now.
But Davey had an even bigger problem. Out of all the brothers, he was the smallest.
That's right. Anyone is bigger than I am.
And sometimes his brothers would try to pick on him.
Oh, Davey! One of my sheep fell over. Will you come pick it up for me?
I'm kind of busy right now.
Do you want us to dip you in tar and stick you to the backside of an angry baby kangaroo?
I'll be right there.
Oh, Davey, one of my sheep fell over too.
1 minute.
Looks like all my sheep fell over. Davey.
Hey, Davey, after you picked up our sheep, could you run and get me something to eat? I'm famished.
Oh, yeah, me too. Get me something to eat, too.
You know, sometimes I think I can eat a whole camel.
Oh, yeah? Well, sometimes I think I can eat a whole spaceship.
What's a spaceship?
I don't know.
This is how things work with Davey. Nothing exciting happening. Until one day, their dad, Jesse, came up with some terrible news.
Whoa! Davey, can you pick those up? Thanks. Oh, boys! Oh, boys! I've got something to tell you! Terrible news! The Philistines! They are tagging!
The nectarines are quacking.
The lima beans are lacking.
One more time, please. And let's work on our enunciation, please.
Okay. The Philistines are attacking!
In that case...
Whoa. Stop the boom.
What?
What is it?
Hey, Kinnat, quick question. What are the Philippines?
The Philippines are a group of islands off the coast of Southeast Asia. That's not important right now. The Philistines, on the other hand, are the people who hated Israel. They want to take Israel's land and make Israel their slaves. So they had to do what the Philistines told them to do.
Ooh, it's bad.
Certainly is. So the Israelites have to protect themselves.
We have to protect ourselves! But how? King Saul is putting an army to stop the Philistines. So they need your help. You must save Israel!
We must help save Israel!
Oh,
Davey! Where do you think you're going?
I must help save Israel!
Wait, tell me you're not serious. Davey, I appreciate that you want to help, but this is saving a country. It's a big thing, and you're just a little guy. What I'm saying is that big people do big things, and little people do little things. So, how about you stay with the sheep? King Saul's camp, the fight lines have been between the Philistines and Israelites as the custom in their day. The militaries arranged it and shouted at each other.
Hello, Israelites. You are pissed. Soon we will place apples in your mouth and stick you in our toaster ovens. Ha 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 ha.
Ah, yes, and when we defeat you, you'll be our slaves and you'll have to bring us our shoes.
Indubitably, and iron our trousers.
And wipe our little noses!
Mm-hmm. And scratch the spot on our backs we cannot reach, no matter how hard we
Scooby-Doo.
So, you got anything to say?
Do you guys have shrimps and pine rib? I could really go for some shrimps and pine rib.
Oh, yeah, me too.
You know, I think we could save us a lot of time. We'll have a battle between our strongest man and your strongest man. And if your champion beats our champion, we will be your slaves. But if our champion beats your champion, you will be our slaves. So, what do you think about that?
Well, the Israelites were becoming weary of all the shouting. And the Philistines seem to be on the little side, so King Saul agreed.
That sounds like a great idea. All right, we agree. Send out your champion.
I go loyal.
Wow. Alvin, tell me about your childhood.
When I was just 3 years old, I left the mallows out in the cold. Nature Blue, what could I do?
Oh, my. Nature Blue, what could you do?
Oh, Nature Blue.
I see.
On the day I got my teeth, I had to kiss my brain and
Hey, can I have a
here about my lips.
Oh, look at the time.
Time for more study.
Okay, back to Davy and the Jumbo Triangle.
Who will I fight?
The Israelites were so scared of Goliath that they all ran away and hid.
No one to fight. I'll come back tomorrow.
And that's exactly what he does. He comes back the next day, and the next day, and the next day for 40 days.
So every time he shows up, all the Israelites will run away and hide?
Exactly.
Okay, then speaking of which, what about Davy?
I was just about to get on with that. You see, Jesse was a little worried about the brothers, so he sent Davy out with some food. Now, at the battle between the Philistines and the Israelites, it's been a little quiet because Goliath's out, and all the Israelites are hiding.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Shh! Can't hear you.
Who?
Him! That big triangle over there!
Who will fight me?
Well, who's gonna fight him?
Well, come on, guys, you heard the man, help bring him out.
Hey, there's no way I'm gonna get Axel by this guy. You go!
Are you kidding? He's gonna use me as a toy! You go!
Not a chance, y'all. I still want to keep my brain intact.
Speaking of which, what are you doing here?
I brought you guys something.
Ooh, pizza! Thanks, baby!
Pizza trophy unlocked!
Wow, cheese in the crust! My favorite!
Come on, guys! Have you forgotten? We're the children of God!
Okay, okay, stop the film.
What's wrong?
What now?
Oh, the children of God. The Bible says that the Israelites were God's chosen people. God led them through the desert. He helped them walk across the Red Sea. And whenever they go into battle, God is there with them. They've always known that if God is on their side, they can fight anything.
Whoa. Mm-hmm.
But King Saul and his men were scared of big, tall Goliath. They forgot that God is even bigger.
Oh, dear.
QBD Alvin, you got something on your,
popcorn.
Okay. But, like before, no one accepted Goliath's challenge.
No one to fight. You know, they told me that you were the children of God. You are cowards. No big surprise. I'll come back tomorrow.
I can't believe you guys are letting him say that!
Well, my dear David, it's pretty much simple. Either we become a bunch of deadbeats, or live. I think we're making the right choice here.
No! Someone has gotta do something!
What are you doing? David, you're a little guy! Leave the big stuff to little big people! Did he see me?
No, you're good.
But Davy knew exactly what he had to do, so he went to King Saul and announced his plan.
I will fight Goliath!
Wow, King Saul took the news rather well.
I'm sorry, I think my ears are plugged. I think I've heard you said that you would fight Goliath. You didn't say that, did you?
Why, yes, I did.
Oh. Well, I'm gonna say, that's very kind of you, but, you are a teeny tiny little guy, and Goliath is enormous. I'm so sorry, but this is a job for a big person, not a little boy like you. Ah, music. I know where this is going. You know what? I don't mind this point. Just sing away. Go ahead.
You're big, I'm little. My hand only comes to the middle. I say little guys can do big things too.
Yes, but the lion, he's
big, but God's big.
the shirt, it will only take a minute. There's a closet in the corner, you'll like what I got in it. You'll find my royal armor there, don't have me put it on. Now you look much better when the battle lines are drawn. Now one more thing you'll need, I think it's right. It's a royal sword, the biggest beauty, the best you could afford. Once you tied it all together, I think you'll agree. You're bound to do much better if you try to look like me.
Exactly sure what he was getting into, but he knew God would be there with him. So he went down to a stream and found 5 stones. Then he went back to the camp and waited for Goliath.
Who will fight me?
I will fight you, Goliath!
If I'm not mistaken, that sounded like David.
David?
Goliath was really surprised.
hopeless. To a lost man. And what the Lord has to say in his book. Say we know that the Lord is wise for everyone, and now that the sun's gone, let's go take our Lord.
Now in our story, no one thought that David could do anything important. After all, he was just a little guy. Why, even King Saul tried to put David on his armor. And it kind of reminds me of another guy who thought he had to put on a costume to be special.
Yeah.
But David loved God so much, he knew that even though he was small, God could make him do big things.
I'll say, he literally took on that old Goliath when all the other guys were too afraid to try.
But that's not all, QBT Alivn. David went on to be the King of Israel.
That's pretty good for a little guy.
That's pretty good for any guy.
Yeah. Wait a minute. If God can help David do big things even though he was little, then that means I don't need to dress up as a superhero to be special.
Nope. Alivn the Cone, you are special just the way you are.
Thanks, Jimbo.
Hey, what do you say to you see if Corey 2.0 has a verse for us today?
That, my friend, is A-OK.
Corey 2.0, do you have a verse for us? With God, all things are possible. Matthew 19:26.
Oh, goody. Because I've always wanted to be a hiccup chicken. Do you think God could turn me into a hiccup chicken?
What? No. That's not what the verse means.
It's not?
No, it doesn't mean that we can do whatever we want. It means that anything that God wants us to do, we can do.
Oh.
So, God wanted the Israelites to win that battle. But that meant someone had to fight Goliath. And even though David was just a kid, he knew that if God wanted him to beat Goliath, he could do it. That showed that how much David trusts God, and that's why he became the King of Israel.
Wow. So, anything God wants me to do, I can do. That actually makes me feel pretty special. And Alyssa, I hope that makes you feel pretty special too. Oh, and by the way, Jimmy, one more question.
Ask away, Alivn.
So, does this mean I can't pretend to be QBT Alivn anymore?
Alivn, as long as you feel okay about being yourself, I think you can do anything that you want. You're very special.
Oh, great.
Well, we're out of time for today, but remember, the Lord made you special, and he loves you very much. Bye!
Hey, mind if I hang out here for a while?
Okay, then. Just don't forget to clean up.
Who is this hero? I am QBT Alivn, otherwise known as Quantum Bio Titanium Alivn.
Telling him to lie about it so he won't get in trouble. So what should he do?
Yikes.
Oh my! Oh, you better believe it. So, everyone, and including you, Felipe, grab your popcorn, dim down the lights like you're in a movie theater, and we're gonna watch Shapetales.
Kid, looks like you got a problem there.
Huh?
If you can understand my understandings, I think I might be able to help you.
Mr. Fuzzy can talk?
Well, I've never been called that before, but yeah, of course I can talk. Actually, my name is Sheldon J. Plankton. Well, you can just call me Plankton.
Wow, you must be new around here.
I guess you could say that. But anyway, you see, I couldn't help but notice, but you broke the plate.
Yeah.
And I don't think your papa is going to be happy about that. Okay, here's what you got to do, kid. You need to have a story.
Like a bedtime story?
No, not like a bedtime story. You need to come up with a story about somebody else breaking the plate.
You saying you want me to lie?
What? No, not a lie. It's just a little fib. People do it all the time. You can trust me. A little fib couldn't hurt anybody.
Charlie, I'm home.
All right, kid. It's up to you. Break a leg.
Hey there. How was your day today? Oh, man. My plane! My Arctic Unlimited Edition Collector's plane! What in the world happened to it?
Well, it's Carla's fault. She broke the plate. I tried to stop her. She said she had to demonstrate her apple cutter. The apple cutter weren't just great, but cut right through your bony plate. It's Carla's fault she broke the plate, it's true. And that's the thing I had to tell you.
Oh. Well, okay then. If that's what you say, I trust you, Charlie. But I'm very surprised at Carla. I'm gonna have to call her father right away.
You did it! Good job, kid!
Huh? Have you grown?
I'm going to bed. But you were magnificent!
I don't know about that. What's going to happen to Carla?
Don't worry, she'll be fine. Remember, a little fib couldn't hurt anybody. And now it's all over. You're free!
You're right. I don't have to worry about that boy play anymore. I'm free!
See, I told you.
I feel great. A little fib couldn't hurt anybody. You're right!
That's it, my boy. Come on now, kid. Let's go and have some more fun.
Alrighty. I rip you all away, Plankton.
Cutie D. Alivn. Mr. Alivn. Can you hear me?
Cutie D. Alivn loud and clear, Alfred. You can go right ahead.
Okay. So, have you located the creature from underwater?
Unfortunately, no. QBT Mobile and I have been all over Pugsleyville, and we haven't seen anything that came from underwater. We even headed to the lagoon, nothing there.
Nothing at all?
Well, we did see this weird-looking gargoyle. Oh, and a big metal turtle.
Oh. Well, keep looking, Master Alivn. Remember, the security of Pugsleyville rests in your, magnets.
Don't worry, Alfred. If there's a dangerous creature from underwater, QBT Alivn will. What's up, boys? Wait a minute. You. Yes, you. Aren't you the same creature from underwater that the news reporter's been hearing?
No, actually. I'm his brother, Plankton.
Oh, okay, that makes a lot more sense. Well, be on the lookout for your brother because he is apparently a dangerous criminal. Okay, doodles!
Hey, Charlie!
I'll be right back.
Hi, Perry. Charlie, I came from Carla's house, and she got in trouble breaking your dad's bowling plate. And she's saying she didn't break it. She said you did. Who's telling the truth?
Oh, well,
she's right.
Huh?
Carla didn't break the plate. It was, Lanny.
Her brother?
Lanny's fault, he bought the plate, he's very naughty. The times are wrong around here, your arms are gone. You gave it to an alligator who chewed it up the choir wall. It's Lanny's fault, he bought the plate, it's true. And that's the tale I have to tell to you.
Whoa, I didn't think Lanny was capable of that. I mean, he's a nice kid. I did not even know he had an alligator.
Yes! It worked again, Plankton!
Plankton?
You
put a few pounds on myself, but no worries, Charlie. I'll always be that little plankton.
Have you always got legs?
Yeah, I always did. But forget about me. Charlie, what a story! You are marvelous! You got a gift there, kid!
You really think so?
Absolutely! You got what it takes!
What do you mean you can't find it?
I'm telling you, Alfred, I looked everywhere, even the lost city of Atlantic City. It's just not there!
Master Alfred, I have gone over the data from the people who are looking underwater, and I have to agree with them. Something from underwater has came up to Pugsleyville.
It's gotta be around here somewhere.
Okay, Alfred, I have been driving around all day. A, I'm tired, B, I'm hungry, and C, I really gotta use the bathroom. And not to mention, I'm a little bit constricting of looking for a few hours. Can I just go home and take one little break?
But the security of Pugsleyville rests in you!
Alfred, please!
Hi, Daddy! Why are you doing this to
fancy your little fib you did. I am grown. And I am big now. So it's my turn to call the shots in this city. And Charlie, you belong right to me.
Stand down, Sheldon.
Huh?
If anyone can stop placing, Cuba D. Alvin can. Put the cylinders down.
Well, why don't you come and make me, little blue man?
Oh, so that's the way it's gonna be.
Cuba D. Alvin, what's happening?
Well, you're not gonna believe this, but the monster is actually Sheldon J. Plankton, heading towards the Pugsleyville Water Tower, and he's carrying a small cylinder. So we gotta find a way to stop this fiend, and fast.
Okay, I'll get the computer going right now. Can you get to the water tower?
I don't think I can. The road's blocked. Gotta travel on foot.
Ah, you're in luck. I made a new modification to the QBT, Obi. It should help you.
What, you have?
Yeah, a little tinkering. I like to do it in my spare time.
That's what the new buttons are for.
Yeah, but I didn't have time to label them.
Should I be concerned?
No. Just do everything I say, and everything will be just fine.
I think we're doomed.
Let's see if your little buddy can help you from up here.
To go and wake him up. Never mind, he's away.
Now, once you get up to speed, you're the most pleasant man button. No.
Alfred, I'm going to run on the road. Wait 5 minutes.
The purple button. Press the purple button. The red button.
Wipers! His wipers on. It's part of his plan.
It's official! I am going to die! Stop yelling at me! Stop yelling! Orange!
In the la-dee-da is that?
So, this is what you do in your spare time.
Not all of it. I've been doing, this and that.
Okay, so how do we stop Sheldon?
About Sheldon. So, Plankton is growing fast somehow.
How is he doing it?
Someone's been telling a lie, so it must be a lie. What's a lie?
He is.
Which part of it? Again.
Alfred?
Yes, Cupid Tiana?
Not to rush you or anything, but now might be a good time for you to tell me how to stop plankton.
Yes, of course. According to my calculations, you can do
nothing.
As in nothing at all?
Yes, as in nothing at all.
If I can't do anything,
then why didn't you tell me that before I jumped on his head? We're not yet finished. You were doing a thing.
Curse my blind ignorance.
Even a little lie can get really big, really fast. And a big lie could just swallow you up. And you, Charlie, have made a really big lie.
Charlie, I'm sure it was just an accident. Just wish you would have told me right away.
But I thought you'd be mad at me.
Charlie, you are much more important to me than any old bowling player.
I think I should be punished. Well, what you did was kind of more punishment enough. What do you think, Daddy?
I think you're right, Mom. Now let's just make sure that from now on, we get the true story the first time.
Doesn't it just warm your heart? Because one man, one magnetic hero were always there when Pugsley Girl eats. QBT Alvin? There he goes again.
I'm here, QBT Alvin. Why not as? What a fight! Hey,
this new plan of yours work this time, Sheldon?
I think I'm gonna stick to stealing the Krabby Patty secret formula.
That's one thing you and I can agree on.
Wow! That was something there! Good job, QBT Alvin!
Thanks, Jimmy! And, can we hurry this along? I got a meeting with the action figure people in 11 minutes.
The action figure?
Yeah, that's right. QBT Alvin Media is sweeping the nation. If you're not on board, you're gonna miss the train.
I have never knew that.
But now you do.
Okay, we'll make this fast for you. So, what are you here by Query 2.0 to talk about what we learned today?
That's all we learned. Of a world of lies. To a lies we live. And what are wrong? As to say, it is born.
I know you like the song, but just let it play.
You're right.
So shall we know.
And the Lord always was. Now for everyone. And now that the song's done, let's go take on the.
Thanks. So in our story, Charlie thought the best way to get out of trouble was by telling a lie.
Mm-hmm. But to cover up for his first lies, he had to tell more and more lies until finally he was trapped, a slave from his lies.
That's right. He thought lying would set him free. But the only way for him to be free is by telling the truth. Let's see according to what was a verse for us today. The truth will set you free. John 8:32b. Now, Felipe, the only way for us to be free is doing what the Lord says and telling the truth. I'm not going to say you'll get punished for what you did, but as Charlie learned, facing your parents will be less painful than getting stuck in a big lie.
Ooh, is that right? Well, gotta clear the stage now, Jim. It's time for the world premiere of my new music video.
You're what?
You're kidding, right? Look down.
Wow. He's not kidding.
Alvin, we need to talk after this.
Alfred, I've got some work to do. Consider our game?
Communicate. Alvin. Lean to me. Ben. Communicate. Alvin. Out of sight. Communicate. Who do they call when Bugsy Bill's in trouble? Who's got the suit with super high magnets? There's a dog independent to fix guys and mannequins and don't get to stay for days. Oh, you need a hand, he's right there on the double. Hey, hey, he's on the way.
Left to do.
What are you doing?
I should have done all along.
super magnetism away!
Looking for a few hours!
Clean me, red machine, looking great.